What's a good slash fun way to waste your Sunday before you have to go back to work on Monday? Imo, the best way to waste Sunday is by tricking yourself into being slightly productive. Do something minor like laundry while you play video games or watch movies. Otherwise Monday hits way worse. Yes, I hate waking up Monday feeling pissed I didn't get any laundry done when I had so much time. Getting up between matches to switch laundry over and folding slash hanging while watching a movie is the only way I can do it. Then I wake up Monday feeling slightly better about myself. Dive into any niche hobby you can imagine. Everything from music, reading, exercise, gaming, journaling, drawing, etc. all have online forums or videos you can watch and learn more about. Even if you never try it again, there's a feeling of satisfaction from trying something new. Video game all day, Netflix all day, YouTube all day, hit the gym, play basketball, then do any of the above. Currently Reddit all day. It's been Reddit all day for 3 months now. What am I supposed to do? Do a nice jigsaw puzzle while listening to a podcast, followed by Louis CK jerking you off, right? Yay, wait, oh, yay, wait, I thought he made you watch while he jerked off to you. The username makes sense once you realize it belongs to Louis CK. Bold of you to assume I'm not already working on a Sunday. I also work today. I'm using this thread as inspiration for Monday, which is my Sunday, or Saturday, both. I can't be bothered to figure it out now. It's Friday night. I essentially have two part-time jobs both on shift patterns. I have no idea when I'm meant to be right now. That's actually even better, oh no. Going places during the day on Monday when it is much less busy is awesome. Saturday is my day for fun, like hiking. Sunday is my day for doing productive things like groceries, shopping, cleaning, laundry, yard work, etc. Look at this overachiever here, using their days off productively for health and personal betterment and crap. I know, right? What the heck is wrong with him? My days are swapped. I do all my productive stuff on Saturday. This way Sunday is totally free of any responsibilities. Ditto. For me it comes from a childhood of chores on Saturday and church and family on Sunday. Cut out the church along the way and the family has dwindled quite a bit, but the formula has worked for me for nearly 5 decades. And I absolutely refuse to do hard thinking after 5 on Sunday, and except for the rare circumstance, must be home by 6 or 7. I need that chill time before facing the prospect of returning to work. Have a nice long sleep, eat some good healthy meals, go watch a movie, and, I cannot stress this enough, heroin. Edit. Thanks Mr. Pointanon for bursting my gold cherry. r/yes yes yes no. Golf. It's like day drinking, but outside. I suddenly understood why old guys love golf so damn much when someone laid it out like this. Outdoors. Sunshine slash fresh air. Buddies. Brand whoring. Bit of exercise. Beer. Watch all 3 seasons of Stranger Things. I'm sorry, you said what? Watch a full season of a show. I'm personally doing this today with Kitchen Nightmares. My wife is cooking dinner tonight, and I can't dive into my inner Gordon Ramsay when she brings out the chicken to taste. It's raw, it's dry, and most importantly, where's the lamb sauce? Wallow in self-pity about the lack of productivity for the duration of your weekend. I started getting back into Legos. As a 33 with money, I can buy whatever I'm interested in. I sit crisscross applesauce on my bed and separate out the pieces. Load up some laundry and turn on Netflix or some music. Whenever I finish a section I change a load or make a drink. It's really relaxing and so satisfying knowing you're getting things done in a relaxing manner yet having fun. This sounds like fun, to be honest. Playing with Legos as an adult is the most fun and satisfying. My favorite part is separating the pieces into little condiment bowls I have by color and size. It feel good. Find a local hiking trail. Pack a bag with some water and a snack. Go for a hike, as short or as long as you are able. Even if the hike is just around the city. Alternatively, pack a bag with some food and water and just don't stop walking. Don't return home on Sunday. Don't return home on Monday. Keep walking and never look back. On the way, you'll find somewhere to buy a new outfit. Get your hands on some new clothes that nobody will ever recognize you in. Preferably with a hat or hood. Make your way to the next country over and set up shop selling hot dogs. Start your new life as Harley Carter and spend the rest of your days selling hot dogs and spinning stories to those who pass by. Your old life, forgotten. You now meet a new love of your life. You will go through years of happy memories before finally getting married and settling down. Your hot dog business is now booming. Your finances are stable and you feel happier than you have in your life. You have two lovely children with your new spouse and the entire family decides to pick up and move to New Zealand to raise the kids and retire. But then, just as you are boarding the plane, disaster strikes. Someone from your previous life is on that plane and they recognize you. They call you by your real name, a name you've all but forgotten after years as Harley Carter. The truth comes out on a public airplane. Your spouse leaves and takes the kids. Your business starts to struggle as its owner and founder is revealed to be a fraud. Then, finally, after years of loneliness and hardship, you are diagnosed with stage 4 liver cancer. It's terminal. You lay on your deathbed, wondering where it all went wrong. At last, an hour before the doctors will declare you dead, you figure it out. You pick the wrong hiking trail to leave on. You should have gone the opposite direction. It just goes in a short loop and you would have been back home soon. Instead, you pick the route off into the unknown, and this is where it took you. Thus, your life ends, funnily enough, on a Sunday. I'm laid off, with a month's severance. I ain't going to work on Monday. I'm actually on my 10th hour of work pouring the Don Mills subway station for double time pay, which is sweet. Usually I'm visiting family, doing laundry, smoking weed, and napping. This is a good change of pace. Awesome attitude. Hopefully work goes quick, and you make lots of money. Quit your job, so you don't have to go in tomorrow. Find a live music concert anywhere in your city. Go to the library. Cook something, if you don't normally do that. Go for a long walk. Make a list of a selection of inanimate objects in your home. Taste them, and rank them from most to least interesting. I'm working today. Personally, I like to get up early and scrub my house top to bottom. Then, around noon when I'm done, I can do literally anything I want without feeling bad on Monday. Today I scrubbed the house and then sat outside at a beer garden while people watching. Now I'm wasting time online. A good day. Hopefully, you live near a well-shaded river, go there, bring a radio, and spend all day laying half in and half out of the water like a fat lazy walrus corpse. My girlfriend and I like to get on public transit and get off at a random stop and then check out the local stores and grab a bite to eat at a restaurant that looks good that we've never heard of. It helps us get to know our new city better and it feels like a small adventure to us. Plus we've found some great hole-in-the-wall restaurants this way. Lay in bed until your phone is charged enough. Then roll over onto your other side and keep on keeping on. Get a robin's egg, some cypress ash, a needle and a knife. Poke a hole in the robin's egg on both ends and blow out what's inside. Fill with ash. Slice open your palm and spill 3 drops of blood on the egg, then throw it onto the floor while you invoke the name of Christ to lay waste to your enemies. Or maybe some pancakes? I mean, if you want a heathen Sunday. Challenge yourself to learn something new. Juggling, how to solve a Rubik's Cube, etc. You will feel accomplished afterwards. Make a PC part picker list, and then realize you're poor. Took a hot bath to loosen old joints. Rode the motorcycle 15 miles to my favorite mellow scatter park. Skated maybe 2 hours, and filmed 20 or so tricks on a tiny quarter pipe. Old and broken causes some limitations. Rode home, took a shower, had a nice lunch. Now I'm laying back with my cat and a video game, waiting to pick my honey up from the airport at midnight. Hell, any one of those things makes a nice Sunday. It's been a fantastic day. I woke up at 5, started making bread, invited my parents over at 8, they arrived at 11 for lunch, they left at 4ish, went to the in-laws for supper, just got home, and I'm in bed, and excited for Monday. I find that hanging out with friends and family is the best way to not suffer from depressing Sundays. Do cool shit, you know? Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click that bell to turn on notifications, so you'll be sure to know when the next video comes out. Want to watch some more? Check out my other videos. I really do appreciate everyone who helps make these videos possible. And as always, thanks for watching.